So tell me, are you ready for your internship? I don't think I am. Hello everyone, welcome to this video. My name is Moyo if you're new, and you're so welcome to She Bites. Today I have a special guest with me, as you can see. This is Mr. Crispin Lieberman. He runs Master Talent Foundation, and this is the foundation that enabled me to come and do my internship in Hofco van Basel here in Belgium. So to start off, if you haven't heard about Master Talent before, you're in the right place. So could you please tell us what Master Talent is all about in the first place?
Yes, thank you. Hello everybody. My name is Crispin Lieberman. I'm the president of Master Talent Foundation, and our purpose is to facilitate international internships, which means we organize internships for foreign students who want to come to Belgium, and we organize internships for Belgian students who want to go around the world for culinary internships. And we've been doing this since 2013. And our goal is to build an international network of young chefs who have the opportunity to gain experience with other talented chefs and to build a network themselves.
Definitely, and that's so amazing. I definitely know so many people who benefited from this. So many people from Beauvais, from Lucerne, are here in Belgium right now, you know, because of Master Talent, and we're enjoying it so much. Everyone speaks so well about it. So the next question I have for you is, what was the journey to building this foundation? You have so many connections, you work with so many people, everyone keeps saying, you know, you're doing such a great job, but obviously we're taking a long way to get to where you are right now.
Absolutely, it's nice to hear that they say we're doing a good job. We started this because we heard that a lot of chefs received applications from students from other countries, non-EU countries, and then they found out that it was not so easy to organize these kind of internships. Mm-hmm. Takes a lot of paperwork, and one of the things you have to know here in Belgium, most of the restaurants and pastry shops are small businesses, family-owned businesses, so they don't have this administration that can arrange things for them. True. So what we do is make it possible for them to organize these kind of internship without the burden of the paperwork and the contacts with schools and with other international partners. So that's how we started in 2013, and in the first period it was mainly students that contacted the restaurants directly.
Okay.
And then with the first students that came from the Swiss Education Group, from the Culinary Arts Academy in Lucerne, and the year after from Le Bouvray also, we had our first contact with the school directly, and then we started to participate at the IRF of the Swiss Education Group. So there we started to introduce the opportunities to organize internships here, and we explained students which options there are, which the different kinds of kitchens and pastry shops there are, the different styles of chefs. So now we try to inform them as good as possible to help them to find the most suitable internship place. And it's a growing network. We're working with a number of other culinary schools as well. But the nice thing is that students that have experience this internship are very content about it and start talking about it in the school but also in their country. So we also receive now applications from graduates, people who say, okay, I've graduated but I'm still interested in learning new things, and for them as well we can organize these internships in Belgium.
Very nice. I want to pick on something that you said, which was that you really try to ensure that you find internships that suit the student. And I feel like that is so important, because internships is quite a long period of time. Mm-hmm. So you have to understand the kind of cuisine that you like, understand the kind of environment you like to work in. And Master Talent gives you the opportunity to learn about the chefs, to learn about the environment. You can always speak you know, to them in detail about what you really want and what you really want to achieve from your internship, and they help you find what is best for you, which I think is one of the most amazing things about the whole network, because you're not just thrown into the deep in someone you know nothing about. You have a background, you have an idea of the kind of place that they are, the kind of ethos that they have, and that is so amazing. So the next question I'd like to ask you is, what impact has all this had on you? From the growth from 2013 till now, how do you view this industry? Have you ever worked in the industry before? Or how do you view it now that you've seen so many students, you know, going through these things and growing and coming out of it?
Yeah, it's quite the journey. We've started this with a group of three people and still working on it with these three people. And one is Chef Jan Buitaert. He's a former Michelin star chef. He had two Michelin star restaurants for over 30 years. And together with him, we started to build a network of restaurants we can work with. And the interesting thing there is, the more you work in this kind of business, the more you see how different styles are developed, which strategies chefs develop to make a kitchen of their own, to design their own plates, to create their own tastes, and that's really a learning journey for me as well. And with the contacts with all these chefs, you learn how the industry evolves. And what we see is that a number of quite interesting things are happening. It isn't all about the Michelin stars and the points at Gomio or the world's 50 best. Some of these places are doing amazing things and using the newest techniques or developing new tastes. And that's interesting to introduce students in these opportunities to learn. And that's what we try to do, because when you as a student have to find an internship place, the only thing you can see is the name of a restaurant, the reputation of a chef. And when you go abroad, you go look in the international gastronomy market, yeah, you'll find restaurants and you'll look at Michelin stars or the points they gain or the place they have on a list, but that doesn't say it all. And the interesting part is that we can help you with this information. We can search together with you what is the best place for you to learn. And it's interesting for us because there we learn what are the points that interest new generations of young chefs, what's the focus of young talent for the moment. So in this way we also can see a bit how the international culinary world will evolve in the following years.
Definitely. And I think one very important thing you just said is how you're looking to connect students with people who help them learn, which is so important.
Absolutely.
I've definitely seen that Hofke Van Basel, my chef, is really supportive. He really follows up with you on how you're learning, how you're developing. And I've also heard that from other people who I know are doing Master Talent internships. So that is very important as well. The next question I would like to ask you is, what has been one of the most difficult challenges you faced running this foundation? Maybe it has to do with logistics or with visa issues. What has been one mountain that has been a bit difficult for you to, you know, climb?
The most intense part still is the paperwork, because inviting students from all over the world is very fun, and it's nice to have all these contacts and all these young people coming into Belgium with a lot of enthusiasm. But to get there, you need your visa, you need all the papers that must be in order. And so for us, something we have to take into account, that sometimes it may take some more time than we had expected.
Yeah.
So that's a challenge.
That's very true. I'll say that from my own visa process, it was a very long process. There's a lot of things you have to do. But once you follow through and you have all the boxes checked, everything works out. It's smooth because they know what you're coming for. But you just have to make sure that you have everything prepared. You cannot leave one thing missing. You have to make sure that every box is ticked, every paper is signed, every stamp you get it, even though sometimes it might be complicated. Especially for me, because I was getting my visa in Switzerland, but I needed papers from back home in Nigeria. And that meant, you know, a lot of logistics, my mom going up and down, but you just have to make sure you have everything that you need. And so the final question I would like to ask you is, what is the most fun part or the most fulfilling part about running this foundation for you?
Working with you guys. It's a pleasure for us. It's just a joy to see how young students come in, sometimes quite nervous because you're in a new country, you don't know where you will come, you don't know the chef yet, you don't know who will be in the kitchen with you, etc. But in the end, everybody is quite happy and is full of joy by these experiences. It's very, very fun for us.
Thank you so much. So you guys have heard it from Mr. Yeoman himself. You have heard the full details all about Master Talent Foundation. You can learn more about them and all the restaurants they work with on their website. Everything's going to be in the description below. Their Instagram, their website is all going to be in the description box below. So definitely click below to find out more about them. And don't worry, we're going to be doing a lot in this series. You're going to be hearing a lot more about all the restaurants, about the students who go there, and a lot more about their experiences. So definitely like this video if you liked it. If you've not subscribed, you need to, because there's going to be a lot more videos about Master Talent coming soon. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye.
Bye.